Welcome to this edition of Fabric Spotlight. Today we will be reviewing Challis with the fiber rayon. If you already know how to do my sew-alongs in videos, and if you'll be kind enough to watch at least one ad should it appear, which enables me to keep bringing you free content, feel free to skip ahead to go straight to the pattern spotlight. Skip ahead to the 3-minute 20-second mark.
Here's a little bit about how I do my Sew With Me sew-alongs.
For techniques, I'm going to put it on the website and I will reference it in the sew-along itself. So for example, we're working on a pair of pants that has a fly front. So when we get to that portion in the sew-along, I'll do a little bit of it, you know, in instructions in the sew-along itself, but then I'm going to refer you over to the website to go ahead and look at that video, that particular video, look it over, you know, study it, do your own sample if you want, because you know I'm big on that technique binder. So go ahead and, you know, and do that. And then once you get a good hang of what that technique is, then come back onto the sew-along itself and do that particular technique with the sew-along. So that way, we both kind of benefit. You still get the instruction of the actual sew-along, step-by-step of how to do a particular thing, but it's less editing on my part because, like I said, I'll mention it in the sew-along itself, but then I'll refer you over to the website to actually find that particular technique and go ahead, review it, look at it. And then once you master it or enough to where even so long, you know, at the same time and install it in that particular so long that you're doing at that time. So hopefully that will be okay for you, because I think it's I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank everyone for watching my videos. I love to upload the videos. I love to share my knowledge. And I'm pretty sure that you guys love to get free content. So in order for me to keep uploading free content, I just need you to do some simple things for me, some very simple things. The first thing is just to hit the subscribe button. So just make sure that you hit that. So you're subscribed to my channel, hit the notification bell. So when I upload a new video, you don't miss out and you get to see it. And then also if there's an ad on my videos, they're typically anywhere from 10 seconds to maybe up to 2 minutes. Just go ahead and either watch it or do something else you want to do in those in that particular time that ad is running. So use the restroom, go get something to drink or something like that. Because that way, if you let that ad run, I benefit from YouTube, and that way I can still keep creating content and uploading it for free.
Okay, enough of that boring stuff. Back to the sew along.
Please take a moment to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And also hit the notification bell so you don't miss any uploads. Thanks again and keep on watching. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about Challis. It's a woven fabric. It's typically made from man-made fiber rayon, which is soft and breathable. It can also be made from a natural fiber, cotton, which will give it a stiffer silhouette. Typical characteristics are it's lightweight, it's thin, breathable, drapey, flowy, and soft. Okay, and it also can be hard to sew because of its slippery nature. Okay, so now let's look at the fiber rayon and talk a little bit about that. Rayon is a silky and flowy, or it has a silky and flowy silhouette. It drapes nicely. It's lightweight, thin, breathable, soft to the touch. It's also absorbs moisture well. It stays cool. It's airy in warm weather. It doesn't wrinkle a lot, but it can be weak when wet, and also can be difficult to sew because of its slippery nature. So how do you sew with Challis, and we'll just use rayon challis because that's typically what you'll find is rayon challis. For needle, you will want a Microtech sharp needle, size 70/10, and use a new one for each one of your projects to avoid holes being made in your fabric. Okay, for thread, you want to use a polyester thread, 100% polyester thread, or you can use a combination of cotton and poly, but poly is will do just fine. For your machine stitch settings, you will use a straight stitch. Walking foot, I do recommend using a walking foot because it is a slippery fabric. Pre-treating or dry cleaning your garment. So it's basically how are you going to care for your garment after it is made. But I typically wash it, and I'll wash it in hot water, dry it warm temperature in the beginning, and then my regular care I always do just cold. But because rayon and challis, they shrink, you want to make sure to pre-treat them before you make your garments. Very important, because they won't fit afterwards. Cutting, you want to make sure to use a rotary cutter, and you can use weights on top if you like, or just pen, and use sharp pens for your pinning. But most definitely use a rotary cutter, because you want to not pick up the fabric as much, because again, it's slippery and shift, and things could be off if you use scissors and, you know, pick up the fabric and things of that nature. So you want it to stay as flat as possible. And another tip is to use tissue paper underneath when you're cutting, because that'll help the fabric not move as much. Marking tools and techniques. First and foremost, you want to avoid marking pens because they can leave a stain mark on the garment. So instead, you want to use chalk or tailor tacks to mark your fabric, okay? Ironing tips. You definitely want to use a pressing cloth, and you want to press versus iron. Now remember, pressing is, you know, you hold the iron in one spot, lift it up, move it to another spot, versus ironing when you go back and forth. So with this one, you want to make sure to definitely press your fabric and use a pressing cloth. Okay. For interfacing, you can interface when necessary, but you want to make sure to use a fusible sheer weight interfacing, okay? Because that does not affect the drape. Because you got to remember, rayon challis has a very nice drape, so you don't want anything too heavy that would affect that drape. Okay, your seam finishes and hems. You can just basically serge or zigzag, and that will work well. For your hems, I suggest a single fold 5/8 blind hem. Again, it just helps to keep that drape, because if you double fold, it creates more weight down there. So you want to just keep the hem where it will be light and airy. So a single fold 5/8 hem will work just fine. Any special tricks for cutting and sewing? Again, just pin. You can use weights, pattern weights, but most definitely use a rotary cutter. And another trick is you can use spray starch to spray down wherever you're going to sew, and that stiffens that particular area. So when you sew it, it won't move as much because it's stiff, because you put starch on there. But once you wash it, it'll go back to its regular drape properties. Now let's take a look at some characteristics of rayon properties. Here I'm showing you that it's opaque. You can't see basically through the to the blue board underneath. All right, now I'm showing you that this is the salvage edge. And we are marking the lengthwise stretch to see what it is. I'm counting down to 4 and stretching. And that gives you about 1/4 inch of a stretch on the lengthwise. Now I'm flipping it so that it will, this the fold will be perpendicular to the salvage edge. And this is your crosswise stretch. And again, I'm counting down to 4, and then I'm stretching. You see that's 1/2 inch stretch there. Now we're talking about drape. So if I hold it up and let it go, if it basically piles up on itself, that's indicates a nice drape. And as you see, it definitely is piling up on itself once I let it go. Next is translucent. So I'm holding my hand right underneath it, and usually if you can see my hand, that means light can go through it. And on the white part, you can barely see my hand. So that's why I say it's low, little light comes through it. So it's not very translucent, but on the white part, you can see my hand just a little bit. So this next one is that if it falls close to the body, just think of my arm as your body. And so I'm lifting it up and letting it go. And as you see, it falls nicely to the body. So you can just see, like if you're wearing a dress or pants, that will definitely fall to your body. All right, so seeing how it wrinkles. Remember, this is a rayon challis. And it does show that this does wrinkle slightly, not a lot, but just slightly. You see little wrinkles, and as you can tell, I've really bunched it up in my hand. All right, so that is your challis and fiber rayon.